and welcome to Body Beautiful. I'm Janelle Marie. This is the show where we talk with local professionals about the latest in medical devices and procedures. Today we have our good friend, Dr. Joseph Mealy. He's a plastic surgeon in Walnut Creek. We're going to be talking a lot about a lot of stuff. We've got breast augmentation lift. We got mommy makeovers. We got facial augmentation. And we also are going to talk about breast implant removal. Remember, any advice we give you today, consult your physician first. Dr. Joseph Mealy, welcome back.
Thank you. So nice to have you back.
It is so great to have you as well. And we're going to be talking about a lot of stuff. But let's start with breast augmentation lift. Now, that's very popular, breast augmentation. But why would we need the breast aug lift, doctor?
The lift has a lot to do with if the skin is excessive. So
okay.
If someone has small breasts and the skin is tight, breast augmentation usually takes care of both shape and size.
Okay.
But if someone has excess skin, say after weight loss or after pregnancy, after breastfeeding, sometimes just putting an implant in there doesn't fill the skin appropriately, and we need to tighten that skin, which is what a breast lift does.
All right, so let's go into the pictures because everybody likes to see the
sure.
before and after pictures, of course. So the first picture we have, what's going on in the first picture here?
Well, I think the pictures really make it real. So
yes.
In this case, we've got someone who has a couple of problems. One, her breasts are too small. She would like them larger, but also very deflated.
Yes.
No fullness at the upper part. It's hard to tell from the front view, but her chest actually goes in a little bit in the middle. And she has quite marked asymmetry. There's a lot more skin
yes.
on the left. And that breast, if you look at the fold under the breast, it's about an inch lower, which becomes a problem because the implant kind of wants to sit where that fold is.
Wow.
And if we leave that alone, she'll end up with that right breast implant being an inch higher than the left breast implant, which is a problem in clothes because we can still see that cleavage at the top.
Absolutely.
So in this case, I had to rearrange the fold, sort of lower the fold on one side, try to raise it a little bit on the other. We did a lift. I did a lift to get rid of the extra skin at the bottom to bring the nipple back up to
wow.
a more centralized position, and the implant to restore the volume that she's looking for.
So you do all that together. What is the recovery time on a breast augmentation plus the lift?
So augmentation plus lift, the recovery is about the same as breast augmentation.
Okay.
Most of the discomfort comes from the implant being placed and stretching the muscle.
Because
I know when I just do lifts without implants, people recover in a couple days.
Oh, that's not
and
bad.
With the implant, first 2-3 days, it's sore. And by the end of the week, then it's feeling good. And most people by a couple weeks are back to doing everything they want to do.
And I know a lot of people are concerned about scarring. And this has a lot of scarring because of the lift. Is that true? Or
in this case in particular, yes, because the incision goes around the areola, down to the bottom of the breast, and then across the bottom. The fold incision, the one that's under the breast, is usually pretty hard to see. So that doesn't tend to bother people as much.
And of course, they'll go away with time.
And right. And then there's just no way to get a better shape.
Let's go into picture number two, talking about shape. That is a beautiful before and after picture there. Picture number two, tell us about that.
So this is a little bit easier, and this is very soon after surgery. You can see the skin is a little bit pink in color.
Yes.
It's natural to get a little extra blood supply in the breast as it's healing. So sometimes it looks a little red, and occasionally people will call concerned that it's infection.
Mm-hmm.
But if it's not painful, there's no drainage, normally that's something we see after surgery.
And so she's probably back up to work in, what, a week?
Again, about a week. Yeah, 2-3 days it's sore by the end of the week. Most people are good. Like driving, things like that. If you're not taking narcotics, most people are driving by 3 or 4 days. In this case, part of the problem is the nipple is very, very low on the breast.
Yeah.
You can imagine if I just put that implant in there, the nipple would still be hanging on the bottom of the breast, which is not ideal.
Now, a lot of people are concerned. Let's go into picture number three while we talk about this. A lot of people are concerned about nipple, getting your feeling back. Now, what's the deal with that? A lot of women are concerned if they go in for augmentation, they're not going to have the feeling in their nipples. Is that true?
I think about 85% of the time, there's really not any change.
Oh, that's
the
good.
Majority of the 15% where there is change is temporary.
Okay.
The most common change being hypersensitivity rather than loss
gotcha.
Of sensation. And over time, it gets back to normal. It is possible to lose sensation and have it stay lost, but that's not the most common. Outcome.
All right, our third picture, another beautiful before and after, very natural in the after picture. What did you do?
So again, what I've done is add an implant to add volume and projection to help with the shape, and then the lift is to get that nipple up in the right position and get rid of that overhanging skin at the bottom.
Yeah.
We call it, you know what the pencil test is? If you can
yes.
hold a pencil under there. Well, in this case, we're trying to not have a book under there because there was a lot of skin hanging down.
I could do a stapler at some one point, so I get what you mean there.
TMI. Thank you.
Let's
but
go.
That's an easy way to tell. And an easy way to tell if you need a lift is if you put your hand behind the breast with the fingertips at the fold and then bring your thumb and fingertips together. If your nipple's below that level, probably a lift is going to be helpful.
Oh, okay. Let's go into the final picture.
Sure. So same idea here. The breast looks kind of just deflated and flat.
Yes.
So in this case, the nipple didn't need to go up as much. In this case, I just did a little periareolar lift. just to get it up a little, you know, about a half an inch where it needed to be, and then the volume restoration is with the implant. And again, it's to balance that upper pole. The upper chest really doesn't change a lot with the implant, mm-hmm. but we want a nice taper to the central projection of the breast.
And you can really see the difference in the fullness on the top of the breast in the after picture. I mean, it's such a natural, progression. It just looks beautiful and natural, like you didn't do anything, just gave her a little fullness.
I did nothing.
All right,
and the goal is that not only does it look good without clothes, but the main goal is it looks good in clothes. It fits in clothes. The proportions are appropriate to the rest of the chest and the body.
All right, we have lots more to talk about. Keep it right here on Body Beautiful. We will be back with Mommy Makeovers. Stay right here.
The information and advice given on this program is for general informational purposes only. For medical advice on specific treatments, medical professionals should be consulted. You should not initiate a course of treatment without consulting a qualified doctor.